Persona!
Hey there, everyone, and welcome to Dende Reviews. I'm your host, Adam, and I'd like to welcome you to my review of Lost Judgment, the latest brawler from Sega's legendary Yakuza sub-series. Now, for those of you who aren't in the know, I'm a massive fan of the Yakuza games. Hell, I even put all the ones I played into a tier list, which at the time was 16 out of 18, and the original Judgment even got an A. Needless to say, I was very happy to see this game announced. Given the recent controversies surrounding Sega and Takuya Kimura's talent agency, this could very well be the last Judgment. See what I did there?
Oh, brother, this guy stinks!
So, I hope this game will be great. Well, let's just see how good this game really is. Unlike the Life is Strange True Colors review, I don't intend on making any jokes that shows gameplay footage, just trailer footage this time again. No spoilers to the spoiler section, you know the deal by now. So, Lost Judgment finally takes Takayuki Yagami abroad, this time to the wonderful setting of Isazaki Ijincho from Yakuza Like a Dragon. I must say, it was an absolute treat being able to visit Yokohama again so soon after concluding the first chapter in Ichiban's journey. Seeing landmarks like the homeless camp, Ichiban confections, the survive bar, and a lot more brought an actual smile to my face. The new additions to Ijincho are just as cool too, with my personal favorite being Serio High and all of its school stories within. Shouts out to my girl Amasawa, the spunky high school detective. I loved her dynamic with Yagami. Sure, she takes some getting used to after her first appearance, but she's honestly quite fun. And shouts out to my boys playing Virtua Fighter in the esports club. Y'all know I love Virtua Fighter, right? I must say though that Ijincho doesn't feel as weird as it did during Yakuza 7, but I will chalk that up to the fact that we're seeing this story through the eyes of Yagami as opposed to Ichiban, and we all know how Ichiban perceives things. It is definitely more fun to get around this time, at least, with the skateboard offering a far better method of transport than just running and taking cabs everywhere. To be honest, I'm a fan, and I want to see this mechanic come back. If not the skateboard itself, then another form of alternate transport, like a bike or something. The plot of Lost Judgment is a definite improvement over the first game. There are a lot of repeating narrative elements, though. For example, Chapter 5 is yet again a lore dump chapter, and if you remember my Yakuza ranking video, that was my biggest drag against the original Judgment. This time though, it's full of mostly dialogue options and interactive conversations, having you solve the mystery from within the Genda Law office. It's almost like RGG Studio fixed all the problems with Yakuza 3 and Judgment's lore dump chapters. And as well as this, Sanri-san goes through the Hostess Maker again. Two times if you really push her the second time around. And as much as I love the Hostess Maker mechanics from Yakuza 3 and beyond, do not get me wrong, I love those mechanics, I must say that the whole, wow, Sari is actually beautiful when she doesn't dress like a total grandma bit is getting old at this point. Sega, you guys can do better than that. Other than those two gripes, I have to give praise to RGG Studio for bringing the heat with a legitimately intriguing mystery and well-written characters. I didn't like Soma much at all. He didn't seem like he had any other motivations besides just getting lost in the sauce like Daigo from Yakuza 4. But he pales in comparison to Kuwana, whose dynamic with Yagami I found to be incredibly interesting, even if it was cliched at times. Trust me, as much as I like this game, if you want a real inspection into what brutal justice versus legal justice is like, just go watch Death Note. There's some plot elements in this game that come too little too late, but we'll discuss those in the spoiler section. For as much as Lost Judgment seems like a straightforward plot-focused title like Yakuza 4 was, there's a breadth of incredible stuff to do in it. First things first, the new snake style is fantastic. It feels like a better version of Taniwara's fighting style. Man, the Yakuza 4 comparisons just don't stop, do they? Regardless, it adds an extra level of dynamism to battles by emphasizing grapples and counters. And on top of that, the style switching speed is increased, meaning that you can swap from crowd control to single full fighting to countering fast as hell. And it can feel pretty busted at times, with you being able to counter bosses easily with Snake, then switch to Tiger to get the best mortal blow counter damage possible. Towards the end, Yagami was an absolute beast. Like, is this dude a detective or is he just Jackie Chan? The skateboard, as I mentioned before, makes getting around so much better. at least in Ijincho. It's not entirely advisable to use it in Kamurocho. Grinding the rails and ollieing over pedestrians never gets old though, especially when you get to the skate park in Hamakita Park. There's a bunch of new minigames this time around as well, like a surprisingly fun boxing minigame, motorcycle races, robot battles, a fully playable Sega Master System, and even Sonic the Fighters? Quite the odd game, no? I still did enjoy myself in the arcades this time around, though. Perhaps Yakuza 8 will add in some truly insane arcade games. Maybe the return of Cyber Troopers Virtual On from Yakuza Kiwami 2. Maybe Crazy Taxi or Daytona USA. I think that the amount of racing games in RGG games prove that Sega can still make fun racing games. Like, the skateboard racing tracks are insanely fun, and I had more fun with that than with Dragon Kart in Yakuza 7, if I'm being completely honest. Lost Judgment also features some DLC, though at the moment there is only a single pack available, featuring some cosmetics for your dog, some skateboarding stuff, extracts, some girlfriends, and that's about it. School Stories expansion is dropping next month with expansions to the robotics team, the dance team, the boxing club, all that stuff. But I want to briefly discuss the Kaito Files DLC coming next spring very quickly. So, given all the disputes between Sega and Takuya Kimura's talent agency, Lost Judgment could very well be the end of the Judgment series. Kaito's getting his own 10-hour solo romp soon, and I can't help but feel that this DLC is a bit of a test to see how well Kaito can function independently of Yagami. Personally, I'd be fine if Kaito stepped into the role of protagonist. He's remarkably intelligent, incredibly charming, and fights with a style similar to Kiryu's brawler style. Although, perhaps it's personal bias, but I'd rather see an Akiyama solo game before the continuation of Judgment any day. All in all, the gameplay for Judgment is the best brawling gameplay in an RGG game to date, and I can hope it only goes up from here. The minigames are also top-notch. Real good stuff, guys.
Howdy there, Jeeves the Robot Butler at your service. Welcome to the spoiler section. Skip to this handy little timestamp to avoid being spoiled. Anyways, on with the review. And remember that likes, shares, and subscriptions go a long way. Love you guys.
Alright, so I have a real bone to pick with Mitsuru Kusumoto waking up. I think initially it posed an interesting plot point, but I think it didn't really go anywhere by the conclusion of the game. It comes towards the last 20% of the narrative, and the kid only has like 15 lines of dialogue, and I think that's a bit of an exaggeration. Like, there's really nowhere for him to go. His mom presumably lost a job and left him high and dry while she's in jail, and he essentially has nothing now. How's he going to survive with this weird stigma attached to his name and with no knowledge of the past decade and a half? Weird. I wish this would have come earlier in the plot, as it would have added more tension, making Reiko Kusumoto a larger threat, even if it was just a perceived threat, as she really isn't that much of a bad person by the end of the game. There are a lot of pieces in play when the narrative is really kicking in high gear, like RK, Reiko, Kuwana, Ihara, Soma, Public Security, the Yokohama Lumong. Sure, the narrative comes together in a mostly satisfying manner by the end, but I can't help but feel like there was some fat left untrimmed. I might need another playthrough for my opinions to fully form, but as of right now I'm 40 hours deep, and I can't help but feel that the story was only an 8 when it could have been a 9. So, here we are, finally at the end. I had so much fun with Lost Judgment, much more so than the first game. It's bigger, badder, and all around. A 9 out of 10. This is the best view into the legal side of the Yakuza world yet, and there still may be more to come in the future. The cast of Judgment is just as charming and close as ever, and I'm happy to say that this game eclipses its predecessor and rides its victory all the way to S tier. Thank you, Sega. Thank you, RGG Studio. You guys are rock stars. If you, dear listener, have a passing interest in this game, grab it. If you're still running through the Yakuza franchise, then you've got some serious heat down the line. I promise you, it gets way, way better than Yakuza 3.
Oh, God.